morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Well, how are you?
I'm
pretty
well
good.
Too, thank you.
My name is Thomas.
Steve.
Nice to meet you.
I'm David.
Thomas. Nice to meet you.
Abby, nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Hi, Abby.
Nice to meet you. Hi, my name is Abby.
And I'm Thomas.
And we are marketing trainees with Stingham Marine Outfitters. Thank you for taking the time today to meet with us to discuss the enhancement of your current online presence management strategy.
In its first year of operation, Stingham Marine Outfitters has built a solid base with both commercial and recreational fishermen and boaters. We see major growth potential in the recreational segment, which relies heavily on our online channels for information about our company.
Stingham Marine Outfitters is located in New England, and because of this, we experience a decrease in our in-store traffic during the colder months. Between the months of April and September, we experience our peak season where our revenue and in-store traffic intensify. Currently, we have a strong presence within the New Bedford community. However, our online presence needs selected upgrades in order to attract and retain our recreational customers.
Accordingly, we recommend a suite of improvements to reach the recreational segment with Stingham Marine Outfitters' unique offerings, which include access to commercial-grade equipment, a liquor license that showcases local microbrews and wines from the area, and easy dock access to New Bedford's famous whaling museum. Specific online improvements include enhanced website content about those unique offerings, easier navigation between channels, and a posting schedule that appeals to boaters' seasonal interests. We summarize our strategic plan with Buoy's goal is to brand through social media, understand the customer preferences, create opportunities for customer engagement, and to set year-end goals.
Currently, we're operating under what's called a multi-channel business model. What this means is that we have our website and we have our social media platforms, but they're not fully integrated and connected with each other. What we want to do is implement an omni-channel business model. This will allow our customers to have a seamless experience regardless of the platform that they choose to use. It will make sure that they're able to get from our website to our social media platforms easily and vice versa. Although we sell to both the commercial and recreational side of the industry, we have determined that our target market is the recreational fishermen and boaters. This is because the commercial side of the industry has a different culture, so they're not the ones that are going to be active with us online. The recreational fishermen and boaters are the ones that are going to be following us on social media and keeping up to date with the different events and happenings in the area.
This group of recreational fishermen and boaters on average spend approximately $33 million annually on recreational boating equipment and services in our area.
In the marine industry, a buoy is used as an anchored navigation mark. Similarly, our strategic plan of buoy will help to navigate Stingham Marine Outfitters through rough waters while keeping them afloat and anchoring them to the port of New Bedford for years to come.
Like Abby mentioned, Stingham Marine Outfitters is strategically located in New Bedford, Massachusetts, which is in the southeast portion of our state. We're on the bridge between New Bedford and Fairhaven, directly across from the commercial fishing docks. New Bedford is home to the highest valued fishing port in the United States, valued at over $2 billion. The city itself started as a whaling community and has since transformed into the commercial fishing port it is today after the boom of the textile industry. It is also now home to a multi-million dollar scalloping industry, but commemorates its past with a whaling museum in the city.
This commercial port currently employs about 4,400 people. And aside from the commercial industry, there are also approximately 900 recreational boat slips, also used as transient slips for visiting boaters, that are utilized by the recreational fishermen and boaters during our peak season. Because these are the people that heavily contribute to our peak season revenue, we want to make sure that we're taking the advantage to maximize our profits with the recreational boaters. Currently, 55% of our revenue comes from the commercial side of the industry, and only 45% of our revenue comes from the recreational side of the industry. Knowing this, we want to make sure that our online presence is really geared toward these recreational fishers and boaters, because if we can maximize our revenue in the peak season, it will decrease our off-season risk during the colder months.
Before we could come up with our strategic plan of Buoy, we started with online research to learn more about the industry, who our greatest competitors were, what they offer to their customers, as well as taking a look at our own social media to see what we currently offer to our customers. Following this, we had an informational interview with owner Mike Quinn, which gave us a little more targeted information about our company and where our goals were. Combining those first two steps, we developed a customer survey, which was distributed on our Facebook page as well as in-store. And it was important to make sure that we put it on Facebook because we knew that in-store traffic would be low because it was distributed during the off-season and there's not a lot of traffic to our store.
After our survey, we created a SWOT analysis to identify Standard Marine Outfitters' strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. We've determined that two of their largest strengths are the fact that they are located in the port of New Bedford and the fact that they are such a unique company in the industry. By selling to both the recreational and commercial side of the industry, it really differentiates them from a lot of their competitors. And the fact that we also have a liquor license and are selling beer and wine to our customers, it makes us a true one-stop shop for these fishermen and boaters that are coming in and getting different supplies that they need for the day. And this really has given us a competitive edge in the industry. The biggest weakness that we identified is that there is no one person in store that is keeping our social media platforms and website up to date and current. Right now, we're asking our full-time employees to take whatever time they can throughout the day to update these social media platforms and the website.
One of the greatest opportunities that we have ahead of us is that there is this large percentage of recreational fishermen and boaters who have not yet been reached by our current tactics. Now, this group often travels, a lot of the transient boaters travel in groups of, could be five or more, and they're often looking for places to resupply or to explore before they get there. So our online presence can be really geared towards that, making them aware of our location. Another opportunity that we have is that we are approximately 15 minutes from the University of Massachusetts Dartmouth, which offers us a great candidate pool for social media marketing interns that can devote their time to keeping all of our social media and website up to date. One of the biggest threats that we face is that West Marine, one of our major competitors, is located approximately a mile down the road, and they offer a similar selection of supplies to their customers, but all on the commercial side, on the recreational side. So even though that they are that close, if customers go there and they can't find something, they won't have any hesitation in coming to see us, and we offer that commercial grade equipment that a lot of these boaters and fishermen are looking for.
After creating our SWOT analysis, we revisited our data received from the survey to create graphs to demonstrate the disconnects that we discovered when analyzing our current online presence management strategy. This graph demonstrates the amount of our participants that are active on different social media platforms. 95% are active on Facebook, and about 61.9% are active on Instagram. And this graph demonstrates the amount of those participants that actively follow Standard Marine Outfitters on Facebook or Instagram. Of the 95% that are active on Facebook, only 28% follow Standard Marine Outfitters. And of the 61.9% that are active on Instagram, only 5% follow Standard Marine Outfitters. Now, this is because of two reasons. Either they're not able to easily find our accounts, or they're not seeing enough value on what we're posting for them to remain engaged, and it's not giving them enough of an incentive to follow us. We also received a comment on our survey saying that they wished that there was a website that they could receive general information about our company. The issue with this is that we do have a website, so clearly our customers are unaware that there is a website for them to obtain general store information, and this is a huge problem. If we create an omni-channel business model and fully integrate our social media platforms with our website, this will eliminate this problem entirely.
The final visual you see there shows the percentage of people that respond to our survey saying that they would be more likely to purchase from us if there was an option to buy online. 52% of the responders said that they would be more likely to, while 48% said it made no difference in their buying habits. We also received a comment on a recent Facebook post where a user showed his frustration towards the fact that we do not currently have an option for them to buy online. Even though we recognize that our competitors do offer to their customers an e-commerce option, it is not something that we recommend Standard Marine Outfitters tries to implement right now. We're just too young of a company with not enough of an online presence already built up to take that large of a financial risk. It could cost us up to $30,000 to get our store online. I'm another reason why we don't recommend it currently is that our website we use right now is built off of WordPress, which doesn't lend itself to e-commerce as well as a website built off of Drupal would. And we strongly recommend that we consider switching over sooner rather than later so that it makes that process in the future a little bit easier. With that being said, we are going to work towards getting our store online, and we're going to use Bowie to help us to get there.
As Tom mentioned, Bowie is going to give us the steps that we need to create an omnichannel business model, which will strengthen our online presence and help us get towards an e-commerce option. The first step of Bowie is to brand through social media. Social media is such an effective and inexpensive marketing strategy that we need to make sure we're utilizing it to the fullest extent. It is essential that we are targeting this group of recreational fishermen and boaters on our social media strategies by stressing things such as our liquor license and the fact that we have commercial grade equipment that they would be interested in purchasing, because it really makes them feel like the big guys, like the pros in the industry. We also have the idea of posting links to different Facebook pages of companies that are also members of the Chamber of Commerce in New Bedford. This will not only allow us to spike community engagement, but it'll also get these other companies thinking about us and perhaps referring their customers to Standard Marine Outfitters as they're looking for places to pick up recreational fishing supplies.
The second step to Bowie is to understand our customer preferences. We know that how our customers view us online will ultimately influence how they view us once they come to our store. We want to make sure that everything that we have online is tailored to the customer, making sure that they feel valued even before they meet us in person. Now, there are a few ways we can do this. We can make sure that our website has easy to find information like store hours or the bridge schedule so that nobody gets stuck in traffic when a big boat is passing through, as well as putting up, maybe in the winter months, videos on how to fix certain parts of your boat you may have broken during the season and that you're thinking about now in the off season, getting ready for the upcoming warmer weather. And this will help to keep our customers engaged with us, but also have them have somewhere to go for reliable information. Another thing that we can do to understand our customer preferences and to really tailor to it is to make sure that our customers know that we offer a selection of wine and beer that is from the area, from local breweries. And a lot of transient boaters, when they come to an area, they're looking to get a taste of what the area has, what the locals drink, and everything like that. And this is a great way for them to do that.
We also want to create opportunities for customer engagement by creating interactive posts on our social media platforms. Some examples of this would be posting a picture of a zoomed-in photo of one of our products and asking our customers to guess what it is. And if we're looking for more informational feedback, we could leave an open-ended question and ask them what kinds of brands or products they'd be interested in seeing us carry. We also developed the idea of creating themes for each month of the year to target our social media around. For example, in the month of June, we'll be targeting our social media around striped bass season. We'll be asking our customers to post pictures with the biggest catch that they have and to tag Standard Marine Outfitters in it. Not only does this give them an excuse to show off their biggest catch, but it'll also allow their friends and families that are following them to be redirected to our page. We also came up with the idea during our off season in the cooler months to have more events to drive in-store traffic. We came up with the idea of inviting our saltwater fly fishermen to come in store and tie flies with Mai Tais. We'll be taking pictures of these events that are going on in store and posting them on our social media pages, which will help to spike customer engagement and get them really excited about the things that we're doing.
Our final step to Bowie is to set year-end goals. These goals will ensure that we're staying on track and will give us a way to monitor our progress. We can look at the analytics from our social media and from our website to view our customer engagement and make sure that we're only investing in the things that are actually helping us to move forward. All of these goals will ultimately work to enhance our search engine optimization and help us to become a more common name in our industry.
The only foreseeable cost associated with Bowie is the hiring of a social media marketing intern. This will be helpful because we'll have someone in-house that's keeping our social media platforms and website up to date. We anticipate that this employee will work 10 hours a week during the peak season and 5 hours a week during the off season. It's estimated that this cost will be between $5,000 and $7,500.
By implementing Bowie, it will help Standard Marine Outfitters to work in a more omni-channel model, which will effectively help all of our will help to increase our revenue during the peak season by reeling in those recreational fishermen and boaters who have not yet been reached by our current strategies. It will help us to work towards getting our store online, making us more competitive in the industry, but it will also help us to interact with local businesses in the area and give recreational boaters options to go visit inside the community of New Bedford.
We hope you're as hooked on buoy as we are, and we'll be happy to take any questions that you have.
Great.